Most of the tribal habitation is in or around forest areas. The survival and development of the tribal community depends upon how rich is the natural resource. But degradation of forest has caused misery and not only threatened the survival but disrupted the family due to fragmentation of the landscape. In view of the above, a project was assigned to IBRAD, Center of Excellence by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Government of India, to have situation analysis of the landscape and culture of Birhor, one of the particularly vulnerable tribal groups of Hazaribagh and West Singhbhum, and also develop methods of skill development and social institution building and bringing change to improve the livelihood of the community is narrated here. Action Research and Capacity Building of the Birhor by IBRAD COE to support for capacity building for livelihood under a project of the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Government of India. There are over 705 scheduled tribe groups notified under Article 342 of the Constitution of India, constituting 8.6% of the total population of the country as per Census 2011, who are an integral part of the cultural mosaic of our population. There are 75 particularly vulnerable tribal groups, where Birhor is one of them. They speak the Birhor language, which belongs to the Munda group of languages. Birhors are found mainly in the area covered by the forest in Old Hazaribagh, Ranchi and Singhbhum districts before these were broken down into numerous smaller units in Jharkhand. Some of them are also found in Odisha, Chhattisgarh and West Bengal. The temporary Birhor settlements are known as tandas or bands. These consist of at least half a dozen huts of conical shape erected with leaves and branches. With government support, the Birhors are now being rehabilitated in colonies with pakka houses, which is found useful by them.
Abhi to suvidha hai.
Jorok kana milta
hai. Barsat aane samay to pani ghusta hai. Abhi plastic diya hai, to abhi utna zyada pani nahi ghusta hai. Pehle ghar nahi tha to kya karenge? Jhopri mein hi rehte the. Abhi to ye ghar acha hai, jhopri acha nahi hai.
Now the Birhor are rehabilitated in the government colony in Hazaribagh, at Demotar and Dhengura, and also in Tatiba of Saranda. Traditionally, they used to make ropes out of the fibers of a particular species of vine, which they sell in the markets of the nearby agricultural people. This has been one of the sources of earning. But in the changing time, such practice of rope making is not in vogue. But due to forest degradation, the life and livelihood are changing. They used to live in the forest and survived on food gathering. The food gathering practices are disappearing due to the scarcity of forest produces. They go for the search of a job, often as a daily wage worker in other farmers' field or nearby market or town. Some have acquired technical skill as mason or tractor driver. The tribes move in the forest to collect forest produce, but cannot get enough. There is strong evidence that many of these resources are facing degradation and the tribes have been suffering from malnutrition. The Birhor remove bark of trees and prepare rope to sell in the market or to farmers. Now, the forest trees are disappearing, so they cannot get bark of the trees. But old habits and culture of rope making continues. So they collect plastic fibers from the local markets and prepare plastic ropes. Birhor, the particularly vulnerable tribal groups, that is PVTG, suffer far more in terms of malnutrition, poor health, lack of education, subsistence-based economy, and remain far beyond the periphery of mainstream development. Realizing the forest of degradation of the natural resource base of the tribal habitat, loss of traditional livelihood base and poverty, IBRAD Center of Excellence, that is, Indian Institute of Biosocial Research and Development, has designed and field-tested unique methods of action research and capacity building of Birhor to support livelihood under a program of the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Government of India. IBRAD organized series of awareness program and conducted training on organic farming for livelihood. Such approaches for introducing new social order and transfer of appropriate technology to address the issue of food security at one hand and climate change on the other hand by involving the community themselves as the partner with the government functionaries. In order to achieve the goal of creating an enabling environment for continuous learning, to build capacity and competency of the community, Prashikshan Shivirs, a semi-structured hub, is established, keeping in mind both the tribal youth dormitory and as outreach center in the line of Farmers Field School to act as a hub for continuous learning. It is the place for conducting in-situ pieces of training at the village. These centers act as open classrooms, Prashikshan Shivir of Tatiba. The training is conducted on a regular basis and not in a piecemeal manner or just for one time. The training modules are integrated with each step of implementation of the project activities following a sequence. For example, just after being trained on land preparation for organic nutrition kitchen garden, the trainers have demonstrated through holding of the trainees on field preparation of land for the nutrition kitchen garden. After being trained, some community take lead to engage their neighbors for adopting new technologies like application biofertilizers in the nutrition kitchen garden, nursery technique, vermicompost preparation. Birhor tribal members have initiated organic nutrition kitchen garden in their homestead and adjoining lands. After getting trained on seed bed preparation, seed treatment, the villagers were actively involved in established the kitchen gardens. In order to explore opportunities for sustainable livelihood options, the fallow lands available in the homestead and adjoining areas are identified to establish organic nutrition kitchen garden. Dry plant parts and green grasses are used to prepare organic composts. These are now put into productive use and people are getting fresh vegetables for their families as nutrition support.
Saag hai aur tamatar hai, isme seem bhi hai, ye sab lagate hain. Tab kheti kuch apna khay bhor ho jayega khane ke liye aur kuch usse जैसे कि हम लोग बेच भी सकते हैं, जंगल जाने से खेती करना अच्छा है।
Bamboos are used for developing nursery structures. Locally available seeds are used for raising saplings. The Birhor learned the nursery training and established nursery. They regularly pour water and learning to take care of plant saplings. Those who have got good result and success in the first time organic garden are motivating others. This is how cultural change will be initiated.
खेती करने का जीवन अच्छा है, हम लोग इससे कुछ फायदा भी होते जा रहा है धीरे धीरे, सब्जी खाने के लिए भी होता है, ओभर निकलता है तो हम लोग बेचबो करते हैं। इब्राड हमको खेती करने के लिए सिखाया है।
The Nutrition Kitchen Garden is raised by Sarita, Manju and Rukmani Birhor at Dengura village in approximately covering 250 square meter area. They are living in the adjoining houses and the land is received under FRA which used to lie vacant earlier. After receiving training from IBRAD, they have initiated the Nutrition Kitchen Garden and are cultivating vegetables and even agriculture crops. Mamta and Sunita are two young women in the same Dengura village who are also raising the Nutrition Kitchen Garden in the FRA Patta land. They have already harvested French bean, gourd, dhania and methi and are now cultivating potato. Vermicomposts are produced for use in the field of the farmers and also to develop an alternate livelihood for them through the sale. Total of 11 units are constructed and is under the process for the preparation of the vermicompost. The progress of preparation of vermicompost got delayed due to the COVID-19 pandemic-related restrictions. The initiatives to develop capacity of the Birhor community members to adopt the new practices and appropriate technology for establishing organic nutrition garden, community nursery, vermicompost units as a sustainable livelihood option is found to be effective. However, it is the beginning and the newly developed habits of the community has to be sustained through strengthening the capacity of the community members to emerge as social change agents for developing a self-organized society by the Birhors.
Gamcha te do mita nalo mita judu ajaro nachova mita lo tum tahi. Gamcha te do mita nalo mita judu ajaro nachova mita lo tum tahi. Am ti tim pano jil laru jo jamgi samana nindo banjoma.